Okay, so this is my second attempt. My camera actually stopped recording for some reason. So I'm going to review Flowers in the Dirt. And this is my world tour pack. I personally think that's the best way you can get the album, is the tour pack. There's the cover. This is actually UK pressing. And these are pretty reasonable on eBay. I only picked mine up for like $12. It comes with a whole bunch of stuff. Posters, postcards, even a 7-inch single. A family tree bumper sticker, which is cool. Tour itinerary. And the 7-inch single is Party Party. And the other side is etched, which is really cool, with flowers. I have it in my 45 box. I should have grabbed it. But, alright. To get to the cover. I really like this cover. It's different from his other albums. Kind of has like almost like a painting in the back with a whole bunch of flowers. Yeah. Here is the lyric sheet. And this is, he worked with Elvis Costello with this album. Here's the sleeve. Just seeing what songs. Just wondering if Costello co-wrote some songs with him, but guess not. I know he sings with on Rough Ride with him. But there's the label. It's just pretty much just like the album. And this is on Parlophone. I don't like this sleeve. I'll probably get a protective inner sleeve for this. I want to mention this is the first time that he's gotten his Hofner violin bass out. And I think he's used it ever since. This album was a big, in my opinion, comeback for McCartney, because his previous albums, Give My Regards to Broad Street, was a flop, which I personally enjoyed. Press to Play, which was a flop, which I didn't mind. It's an okay album, but like I said, not his best. And then he had the Russian album. What was it? Choba, CCCP, or whatever. But anywho, back to this. I'm going to start off with just kind of going through the track listings. Track 1, My Brave Face. Track 2, Rough Ride. Track 2, You Want or 2. Track 4, Distractions, We Got Married, Put It There, and then we go into Side 2, Figure of 8, this one, Don't Be Careless Love, That Day Is Done, How Many People, and Motor of Love. Okay, let's start with Track 1, My Brave Face. I like the bass in this. This song kind of is like a Beatles-esque song. Reminds me of the Beatles. Kind of, it's an upbeat song, but you know, sad. It's kind of like a breakup. And you're keeping my brave face, you know, but it makes you happy. I'll stop that there. It's a great opener. I really like that song. I love the bass in it. I love his vocals. Just a really great song. All right. Track 2, Rough Ride. Oh, he didn't sing with Elvis Costello. Didn't sing with him on Rough Ride. I was thinking of a later song. Brain 2. I like the guitar on this too, it's good. It was You One or Two, these things with them on. That's the next track. I know you didn't get really much of a sample for that one, but I don't mind that song. It's not the best on the album, but it's not terrible either. Track three, You One or Two, which he sings with Elvis Costello. If I remember right, I think McCartney said, in a lot of ways, Elvis Costello reminded him of John Lennon. Working with Elvis Costello reminded him of working with John Lennon, which is kind of cool. And kind of even the vocals kind of remind me of something Lennon would sing. I mean, that's just, you know, my take on it. But I think that, if I remember right, that's what he said. Here we go. You One or Two. A very different song, a different opening. She makes me go so wrong. Yeah, you kept me awake, you know you did. I'm loving oh so long. So why don't you come right out and say it's stupid. She makes me do things I don't want to do. I really like this song as well. It's different. I like the vocals on for both of them. I like how they play off each other in this song. Next one is Distractions, which is a really good song. Kind of it's a slow, kind of lovey-dovey song, you know, a silly love song by McCartney, which I like his silly love song. So, Distractions. Really, really pretty song. What is this thing in life that persuades me to spend time away from you? Kind of just talking about just being busy and wants to be. Probably with Linda. I like his ooze. My girlfriend always picks on me because I like the do's and the ooze and the that he does in a lot of his songs. Next is We Got Married. Kind of almost reminds me of a that he's reminiscing about getting married with Linda. And I really enjoyed this song as well. I wish I could kind of cue it up and let you hear one of my favorite parts. See what I can do. This is on my iPod, so I'm going to try to... 'Cause I don't want to just skip the whole song. I know this is terrible, but I promise it's not a CD or anything. It might take too much to get to. I'm really sorry. I really like this part. Really good. I know that sounded terrible. But really, really like that song, especially for that part. Put It There, which I think, I'm pretty sure he wrote this for his father. And it reminds me of my dad. I'm the youngest. And we just kind of done we do everything together. We go record hunting. He even looks for me when I'm not with him. We flea marketing, everything. Toy shows, because my second hobby is collecting movie memorabilia and figures. So this song holds a special place for me and my dad. Really good song. So this is the opening for side two. Is Figure of Eight. Which I really, really enjoyed this song. This is another great one. There, really great song, and another great song to follow. This one, which I won't. I'm running out of time already. Holy smokes! Such a great song and a really kind of trippy music video. Really great song. And like I said, my beefs again. I wouldn't mind seeing a few of these songs on Pure McCartney, but that's a past review, my thoughts on that. Next one is Don't Be Careless Love. I'm not going to spend too much time on it because it's not one of my favorites on the album. Just not a huge fan of that song, really. It's not god awful, but if I'm listening to the whole album in its entirety, it doesn't bother me to listen to it. Same with That Day Is Done, which is next. I feel such sorrow, I feel such shame. I know I won't arrive on time. Not too bad of a song. It's kind of a sad song. Next is How Many People, which is a great song. I really, really like this song. Love the vocals, love the instruments, everything. How many people standing alive? It's a great song. Almost has like a reggae type feel to it. Really, really good from start to finish. And the last song is Motor of Love. Interesting kind of love song. I actually don't mind it. I wish we could sample a little bit more, but I did want to do Party Party. Not a bad little McCartney love song. Best, but not bad either. If you have the CD, there's a bonus track, Back on My Feet, Flying to My Home, loveliest thing. But I'm just going to kind of do what's in the tour pack. Party Party. Not a super great song, but it's kind of catchy. I don't mind it. It's lyrically, it's not anything. It's pretty much the same words over and over again. Party, party. But I would give this album a 9 out of 10. Really big fan of this album. So that is my review on Flowers in the Dirt. Please comment or subscribe below. Take it easy. Peace. Enjoy your Sunday, folks.